First person we want to talk about in a historical aspect is Democritus. Democritus was not a scientist. He was a Greek philosopher. And he was credited basically being the first person to have the idea that all matter has to be divisible. And you can break it down into smaller and smaller pieces. And at some point, you have to get to an end of that division. And the end of that division is what we now call the atom. We're talking about 400 BC right here. And really not a scientist, not a person who did any experimentation, just kind of developed that idea that there has to be building blocks within nature. Move forward to the early 1800s, and now we get the first scientist who really talked about the atomic theory. John Dalton is accredited for being the first scientific atomic theory, and his atomic theory had five parts to it. The first two parts you see on the screen. Number one being all matter is made of indivisible and indestructible atoms. If you think about this statement, indivisible and indestructible atoms, in the early 1800s, as far as they knew, this was a true statement, and this was something that held up to all their research. We now know that this is not 100% true. We have been able to show that we can split atoms through fission, and we also know that the atoms are divisible. We can break them down into smaller particles such as protons, neutrons, and electrons. So his first atomic theory isn't considered to be 100% accurate anymore. We still use it as a baseline for what the atom is made of, but we also basically have modified it over that time to now include the idea of fission, protons, neutrons, electrons, and even more specifically now into the world of quarks and things that build the protons and neutrons. His second part of his theory tells us that all atoms of a given element are identical in their chemical and physical properties. That sounds like it's a pretty good statement. There's one small piece here that's a little bit mistaken, though. He says all atoms of an element are identical. We now know that elements have multiple versions of them called isotopes. So, again, a slight modification on his original theory to basically talk about what an isotope is. You guys have heard of carbon-12 before and carbon-14 before, used in carbon dating. Carbon-12 is our stable form of carbon. Carbon-14 is the unstable or radioactive form. So over time, carbon-14 decays and disappears, so we can actually date living or past living objects by how much carbon-14 is left over in those cells. His statement doesn't really talk about isotopes at all. So you could easily fix this and say that all isotopes of a given element are identical. All atoms of a particular isotope of an element. So all atoms of an isotope of an element are identical. Because carbon-12 is identical to other carbon-12 as far as we know. But carbon-14 and carbon-12 are not identical chemically, because they have different numbers of neutrons in them. So first two parts, not 100% accurate in terms of what we believe now, but still are very good baseline information for his theory. Parts 3 and 4 still hold true to what everything we believe today. So atoms of different elements combine in simple whole number ratios to form compounds. Basically, this part, he's saying that to make compounds, you can't use a half an atom. You have to use individual atoms or whole number ratios with that. And then chemical reactions consist of separation, combination, or rearrangement of atoms. You gotta remember, in the early 1800s, the concept of things like lead turning into gold and alchemy was still relatively prevalent. So to come out and say that chemistry only can separate atoms, combine them, or rearrange them, what he's basically saying is you can't turn one thing into something else magically. All it is basically a rearrangement of atoms. So it's kind of a powerful statement for that time period, even though today we kind of seen this as common sense. Back then, it really wasn't. So Dalton's atomic theory has four major parts to it. And then within that, the first two parts weren't 100% accurate from his timeline. From Dalton's atomic theory, he was actually able to develop the first model. So as we go through the notes, we'll talk about different theories and different historical backgrounds and then the models that came from that. So his model was as basic as it possibly can be. He believed an atom was the smallest particle. He believed it was indivisible and was not separatable. So, as a result, his model shows that the atom would be kind of like a sphere, where it would just be a solid sphere or ball of mass that was indestructible. You could not break it apart and had no complexity to it. We now know that his model isn't right, that there's more complexity there. However, it was a good starting point in it from a historical aspect. Again, we're talking early 1800s.